In the leather workshop, the Louis Vuitton wardrobe trunk is in the throes of its refurbishment. Martin has removed all of the precious monogrammed rivets.
Last one of 120 rivets.
And he can finally make a start on the refurbishment of the crumbling leather band. If he can get the trunk back into pristine condition, dealer Saxon stands to make a significant profit from his £100 outlay. So he's in London to get a professional opinion.
The main thing I'm looking for today is a valuation on the trunk. I've not sold vintage luggage for years now, so I'm out the market. I don't really know what they're going for.
Luciano Gulshan's family have been in the vintage luggage business for over 30 years. From his shop in West London, Luciano supplies the film industry with period prop suitcases and sells rare antique luggage to collectors across the globe.
I've got a trunk that's being restored at the moment.
Right.
I'd like to know a bit more about it and evaluation, obviously.
Yeah, I'd love to. Have you got pictures?
Right, here we are. It's quite a few.
Right.
Showing the lock, the labelling, obviously the colour, the size, that sort of thing.
Right. It's definitely genuine.
Good.
Ladies' wardrobe trunk.
Okay.
Because of the compartment in the top.
Right.
For the hats. Quite good condition for its age, circa 1920. Very, very good that you've got the original handles. They're usually long broken on such a big, heavy trunk.
Oh, and obviously, of course, yeah.
Leather doesn't age very well.
No.
The elements aren't kind to it. But it will have been a very, very wealthy person to have such a piece.
Yeah, definitely.
With the authenticity of the trunk confirmed, one question that Saxon is undecided on is whether to replace the missing drawers.
What's your opinion on making new drawers for it?
Personally, I wouldn't. I'd keep the originality and the integrity of it because it's all original as it is. If you make drawers, they'll never be correct.
No.
And it's more a piece of furniture today.
Yeah.
The person who buys it is going to go into the corner of a bedroom or a sitting room. It's something to decorate the house.
Definitely, definitely.
As it stands, I would value it at between £3,000 and £5,000.
Right.
And if you polished it up, found some hangers, I reckon 8 to 12.
Good heavens. Wow. That is amazing. I think Luciano was right regarding the drawers and the valuation of 8 to 12 thousand. Wow, that's just amazing.
In Martin's workshop, having removed all the rivets from the band on the Louis Vuitton trunk, he's now preparing it for the next stage of its restoration.
All this needs to come off. When the leather comes in contact with water, there's a chemical reaction between the steel and the leather goes black, and then it goes very brittle.
To replace the original leather band, Martin cuts strips of untreated leather.
This is a leather dye and conditioner to bring the leather down to the colour that I need.
But replacing the leather strip comes with its own set of challenges for Martin to overcome. With this being a Louis Vuitton trunk, even the leather band has its own unique pattern.
This is the monogram. If you can see it faintly, there's a stripe on the very outside, then there's a broad stripe with a narrow stripe on either side of it. What I've got to try and do now is replicate that. This is particular to Louis Vuitton cases. Originally, these patterns and these embossments and monograms are done on huge, big rollers. Now I'm having to improvise and think on my feet, so I've had to make a tool to fit this.
Martin has made a bespoke leatherworking tool which embosses a replica of the Louis Vuitton monogram.
I'll probably only ever use it this time, but if it does the job and gets the job finished, that's all we're looking for, is the finish. It's coming out quite well. What I've got to try and do now is stick it into position.
Martin glues the leather onto the metal band and folds the edges over.
You fold leather with an antler or a piece of bone. It's called a bone folder because it doesn't mark the leather. You can't have steel because steel reacts with it. The monogram on it now, you can see it and feel it. And once that's been textured and once the colour has been changed, once everything, it'll look the part.
With the hard construction part of the restoration completed, Martin moves on to the final polish.
This is a solution I make up myself. Different things I find that works. And you can see the colour changing straight away, look. You can see the dirt coming off. This is 100 years of coal dust and a Victorian environment. Everything was steam powered, so, and it would have constantly been in a polluted atmosphere and gathered so much soil and dirt. This is what you have to get off the surface first.
The original 100-year-old leather trimming that has survived will also need some attention.
When you're dealing with leather that's been round the world God knows how many times, you'll see that just adds a bit of body to it. And we'll just keep on going and just keep on feeding till I think it looks the part.
Just over 3 weeks ago, Saxon brought Martin his once-in-a-lifetime find. Picked up for 100 quid, he's since found out that he potentially stands to make an eye-watering profit.
Having such an incredible valuation of between £8,000 and £12,000, I'm a little bit nervous because I don't think Martin realises, but yeah, if he's got it right, fantastic, but if he's got it wrong, ooh. So this is it then.
The baby, shall we?
Go on then. Wow.
Blood, sweat and tears in that.
It looks incredible, absolutely incredible. The band is unbelievable.
You wouldn't consider it's been off.
It's like it's been always been there.
To get this monogram and get this pattern in it, at the right spacing, it was... I'm hoping you can look at it and not think that it is a replacement.
Absolutely, absolutely.
A lifetime of adventures had taken their toll on the Louis Vuitton trunk, but Martin's restoration has firmly put it back in first class, with a new monogrammed calf-hide leather strap studded with the original rivets, and a buff and polish worthy of its high-class credentials.
I tell you what, it's not my favourite job in the world.
No, I don't know how you do it.
It's probably the first and maybe the last that I ever do. I cursed your name uphill and down Dale for hours and hours, but I'm pleased, I'm so pleased the way it's come up.
Well, I think this is an absolute triumph. I had a vision in my head of my ideal result, and this is it, big time.
Well done.
Yeah,